Removing the meat and preparing a crab can be a bit daunting if you've never done it before, but with a little understanding of the different parts of a crab, and by following a few simple steps as shown in this video, it's really a straightforward process anyone can do. A few simple tools are required found around any kitchen: a chopping board, a narrow-handled teaspoon, and a rolling pin or other such weighty implement which will be used to crack the claws. When selecting a cooked crab from the fishmonger, look for a crab with reddy brown colouring and try to choose one which feels heavy for its size. This is an indication there is a lot of meat within the shell. Avoid any with cracked shells or missing toes. Male crabs have bigger claws and as such usually render more white meat. The female, on the other hand, tends to have more brown meat within the body. The most obvious difference between male and female crabs are the tail flaps, which on the female is much broader and bigger. The first step in the process is to remove the toes and legs. Lay the crab on its back and, holding the body down, pull the toes upwards away from the body. The legs are removed in a similar fashion. The toes need to be split into three separate parts to get the meat out. Firstly, break off the thigh by holding the toe firmly and bending thigh backwards to break off. Using the handle of a spoon, scoop out the meat into a bowl. To break the knuckle, lay the knuckle on the chopping board while holding the toe. Then, using your rolling pin, strike the joint firmly until it breaks. Again, scoop out the meat with a spoon. To remove the meat from the claw, lay on the chopping board and give a firm tap with the rolling pin to break the shell. Pick the broken shell away from the meat and remove the meat from the large cartilage which is found in the centre. Alternatively, the toe can be left intact once the outer shell is removed. This is an attractive way to present the meat in a cocktail form. White meat can also be removed from the upper parts of the legs by cracking gently with a rolling pin and picking away the shell. The lower parts of the legs also contain a little white meat, but this can be fiddly to remove. Once you've dealt with the legs and toes, you're left with the body. This carapace contains the brown meat and also some white within the honeycomb-like structure, the purse. To remove the purse, insert a broad-bladed knife at the back of the shell and twist, pushing the body section away from the back shell with your thumbs. Most of the brown meat within the back is around the sides, so remove the mouthpiece and stomach sac. The brown meat can then be scooped out into a separate bowl. The amount of meat and its consistency can vary quite a lot from crab to crab. Males tend to contain less brown meat than females, and seasonality can also affect the contents. Females sometimes contain roe or eggs. Bright red in colour, this is a highly prized item and can be mixed in with the brown meat. Once cleaned out, the back of the crab is often used for presentation purposes. Snap off the shell along the fault line which runs around the body, then rinse the remaining carapace under a tap and set to one side. To clean the purse, firstly remove the gills, or dead man's fingers as they're sometimes called, and rinse under a tap. Then, using a sturdy knife, cut the purse in two and, using your teaspoon, pick out any remaining white meat. This can be a bit fiddly, but patience can be rewarding. Break up and mix the brown meat with a fork. It's at this stage you might want to add a little breadcrumbs to the mix, if it's a little wet. Other common additions are chopped boiled eggs, a squeeze of lemon, a twist of pepper, chopped parsley, or even curry powder. To finally dress the crab, spoon the brown mix back into the clean shell and top with a little white meat and whatever garnish you fancy. And there you have it, dressed crab.